Good morning to all of you. Welcome to a new session. Hope all of you joined. We'll wait for a few minutes for you to join. We're waiting for people to join. We'll wait for a few more minutes. We discussed few problems from TCS Mark Vita in the last few classes, few in the sense last two classes, and today we are going to discuss at least two problems. So may solve the third one also if time permits. The first problem is lazy student. The second one, this is solved. This was also solved. Collision course is also done. Television sets is done. Now we are in lazy student. So should I start or wait? Seems only two people joined so far. Okay, I start. Problem is titled as lazy student. There is a test of algorithms. The subject name is algorithms. Teacher provides a question bank consisting of n questions. The question bank contains has n questions. Okay, now and guarantees all the questions in the test will be from this question bank. Due to lack of time and his laziness, the student Kodu, student name is Kodu, Kodu prepared only M questions. Out of N, he prepared only M. Or he practiced only M. There are T questions in a question paper. Out of M, T questions are randomly selected. For example. Okay. And Kodu is supposed to solve. At least one problem out of T questions. Okay, so we need to find out the probability first. What is the probability that the Kodu will pass the test? Okay. Okay. No. Say number of questions is same, for example, 10 or 5 questions. Okay. Teacher selected two randomly. Now you tell me in how many different ways the teacher can select 2 from 5. How many different ways the teacher can select 2 out of 5? So I want students to respond in how many different ways the questions 2 can be selected from 5 questions. There are 5 questions. In how many different ways 2 questions can be selected from 5? Come on. No response. Okay. So we can select 2 from 5. In 5C2 ways. Okay. In 5C2 ways, we can select 2 questions from 5. Right? Now, Kodu prepared 2 questions. Out of 5. What is the probability that Kodu will pass the test? What is the probability that Kodu will pass the test? Number of questions are 5. Test contains 2. Kodu prepared 2. Okay. Say total ways in which T questions can be asked from N is NCT or 5C2. Okay. Which is 10. Now, how many questions Kodu prepared? He prepared 2 questions. How many he did not prepare? He did not prepare 3. Okay. Now, how many he needs to solve? At least 1 needs to be solved. 2 can be solved. And Kodu cannot solve more than 2. Because he prepared only 2. Okay. Now, case 1. Kodu prepared 2 out of 2. Okay. So all the questions came from prepared and no question came from not prepared. Okay. Is this clear? Case 2. One from prepared and one from not prepared. One from prepared and one from not prepared. Kodu prepared only 2 questions. He needs to solve at least 1. Okay. If he is lucky, he can solve both the questions. If both of them are from prepared ones. So case 1 is, both the questions are from prepared. No question from unprepared. Case number 2. One from prepared and one from not prepared. Okay. Is this clear? Now, 2C2 into 3C0 by 5C2 is first proposition. Second one, 1 out of 2, 1 out of 3 and 2 out of 5. This is second proposition. Okay. Is this clear? Now what is the total probability? 2C2 is 1. 3C0 is also 1. So 1 into 1 plus 2 into 3 by 10 by 10. The answer is 7 by 10. Okay. Okay. The answer is 7 by 10. Hope you understand it. So there is 70% probability that Kodu will pass a test. Okay. But here you need to do a lot of groundwork. When there is at least one. Okay. If Kodu prepared n questions, at least one, in the sense he can answer 1, he can answer 2, he can answer 3, he can answer 4, and so on, he can answer n. So you need to analyze so many cases. It is always better to find out probability of failure when at least is there. Whenever the word at least is there, so will pass if at least some n questions are answered. Okay, this is always cumbersome, takes lot of time. Look here, find out probability of failure, and probability of pass is 1 minus probability of fail. Okay, what is probability of failure? 5 questions are there. There are 5 questions and Kodu prepared 2 and Kodu did not prepare 3. So Kodu will fail the exam if all the questions are unknown to him. That is, all the questions came from unknown, not from known. Okay. So all the two questions came from unknown. So n minus m c2 divided by n c2. This is the probability of failure. What does it mean? Probability of failure is equal to 3C2 divided by 5C2. Nothing but 3 by 10. What is the probability of pass? This is 1 minus probability of failure. Okay. So in one stroke, you got the value. Okay. Is this clear? Is this clear? Hope it is clear. Now, let us take the input format. Number of test cases followed by number of questions, total number of questions, number of questions selected for exam, and number of select questions Kodu can answer. So, let us start our programming. First part is a probability. Find out the probability. let us further reduce the window size. Well, we don't need this much window. Okay, it can be reduced further. So first is number of questions, the second is questions selected for test, third is questions go to prepared. Okay, space separated values, split at blank space, one blank space, map this into integer, and then make it a list. Okay, so let us call this as data. Okay, what is the first part? En, second part T, third part M. Number of questions is 0th element. Number of questions selected for the test randomly from N. Data 1, and this is say data 2. Okay, now let us print all the 3 and see whether input is properly taken or not. The input case is total questions are 4, 2 are selected for exam, and Kodu prepared one. They are 4, 2, 1. Save this somewhere. Okay, 4, 4, 2, 1. Right. And what is the probability? Total questions are 4. Asked are 2. Prepared are 1. What are unprepared? Unprepared are 3. Okay, so all the 2 questions should come from unprepared. So probability of failure is 3C2 by 4C2. 3C2 by 4C2. What is 3C2? Is 3, 4C2 is 6. So probability of failure is 1/2. So what is the probability of pass? What is the probability of pass is 1/2. Okay, so we should get 1/2, right? Now, how to get it? Probability of pass. Okay, is equal to what? All questions should come from unprepared. All questions should come from unprepared. Okay. That is n minus m c t divided by n c t. Okay, we can write combination of n minus m comma t divided by combination of n and t. Okay, so and this is 1 minus, so you need a function to find out combination. Let us write a function for combination. It will reduce font size. I think it is too big. Let us make it 18. Okay. Define combination input is say n and r. Input is n and r, ncr. It will return ncr. Okay, so what is ncr? Factorial n divided by factorial n minus r into factorial r. I think all of you know it. I need not explain in depth about it. Okay, so this should be grouped. And I want integer value of it. So what I do is I convert everything into integer. Okay. Now, probability of failure, say PF, is equal to combination of N minus M, the questions code did not prepare, and total number of questions, divided by combination of total questions and total questions asked. Okay, again you convert everything into integer. This is probability of failure, right? But here you want probability as P and Q. I keep it like this. I want not exact value, I want the factors. Okay. It is say 3C2 by 4C2. So this is 4C2 minus 3C2 by 4C2. So find out numerator separately and denominator separately. Let us call numerator as P and denominator as Q. Okay. So find out P. What about P? Numerator. P is combination of N, T minus, this is 4C2, minus 3C2, combination of N minus M, unprepared, N minus M, T, this is numerator. What is denominator? This is denominator. Okay. This is denominator. Now let us print numerator and denominator of the probability. Numerator and denominator of probability. Inputs are 4, 2, and 1. Okay. Factorial is not defined. So what we need to do is import from math import all. Okay, and what is the input? What is the input? 4, 2, 1. First is N, second is T, third is M. 4, 2, 1. So we got the answer. Numerator is 3, denominator is 6. Numerator is 3 and denominator is 6. Okay. Next, part 1 is done. Part 1 is done. What is part 1? 1 by 2. What is next part? What is next part? P and Q are co-prime. P and Q are co-prime. What do you mean by co-prime? What do you mean by co-prime? P and Q should not have factors. How do you decide? How do you decide that P and Q are co-prime? When P and Q do not have common factors, then they are co-primes. Okay, that is GCD of P and Q, if it is one, they are co-primes. Okay, for example, GCD of 3 and 6 is how much? Is 3. Okay, to make them co-primes, what we do is we divide 3 by GCD of 3, 6. We divide 6 by GCD of 3 and 6. Okay, what is 3 by GCD of 3, 6? This is 3 by 3. What is 3 by 3? 1. Okay, what is 6 by 3? What is 6 by 3? 2. So what are the factors now? 1 and 2. So they don't have common factors. So they are co-primes. Okay. Is this clear? So what we should do is, if GCD of P and Q, if GCD of P and Q is equal to 1, then P and Q are coprimes. Okay. If not equal to 1, what we should do is P is equal to P by, instead of writing GCD many times, I do one thing. Say let G is equal to GCD of P comma Q. Okay. If G is not equal to 1, then P is equal to P by G, Q is equal to Q by G. Okay, step number 2 is done. Now both are cofactors. Is this clear? Now print P and Q. So for GCD, let us write a function. Define GCD. Inputs are say A and B, which are P and Q. Okay. If A is less than B, you know the condition, A should be always greater than B, then swap AB with BA. Okay, while B greater than 0, you find out remainder. What is remainder? A mod B. Okay, now A is B and B is R. Okay, and you return A. Okay, is this clear? So that A is taken as G. So you know that P is 3, Q is R. Now what are coprimes? Inputs are 4, 2 and 1. Okay, coprimes are 1 and 2. So what we should do is, we should take integer value of it. Because we deal with integers only here. Okay. Or take double division. 4, 2 and 1. So part 2 is also done. We got coprimes also. Now we need multiplicative inverse of second number. Okay. Actually, what is multiplicative inverse? Multiplicative inverse. If GCD of AB mod M no if A into B if A into B mod M is equal to 1, then P is multiplicative inverse of A under the module M. Okay, B is multiplicative inverse of A under the module M. For example, say A B mod M, right? Suppose A is 7, B is 5, and M is 34, then 5 is multiplicative inverse of A under the module M. Okay, multiplicate inverse of 7 under the module 34. Is this clear? Now say A into B and divide it by M. Okay, how many times? Say x times. Remainder is 1. So what is the relation between A, B, M and 1? M into x is equal to or M into x plus 1 is equal to AB. Is this clear? That is A into B is equal to MX plus 1. Okay. Now, A is a whole number. What is this? A into B is equal to module times X plus 1. Okay. That is, if MX plus 1 is divided by A, we get B and remainder is 0. Okay. Is this clear? So if MX plus 1 mod A equal to 0, then B is equal to MX plus 1 by A. Is this clear? Please have a look at it. So return B. What is B? B is multiplicative inverse of A. Okay. Now you see how I am going to implement. What I want? I want multiplicative inverse of A. Multiplicative inverse of A. Okay. A or B? So what is multiplicative inverse of Q? So what is modulus? This is 10 to the power of 9 plus 7. So I want multiplicative inverse of B. B is Q for a module. What is module? Module is 10 raised to 9 plus 7. Okay. So you need this. We need this. And then we multiply that with P. We multiply that with P and then take modulus. And answer should be. What is answer? And this should be the answer. Let us do. It is more of mathematics than of logic. So multiplicative inverse. Function name is define. What is the function name? Multiplicative inverse. Find out multiplicative inverse of say I call this as I call this as A and M. Okay, now what is the logic? So take X from 1 to M, 1 to M, if M into X plus 1, M into X plus 1 modulus A, if M into X plus 1 modulus A equal to 0, then multiplicative inverse of A, which is B, is equal to M into X plus 1 divided by A. Okay, and take integer value of it, or take double division. Take double division or integer value of it. So responses are not coming. Same responses stopped. Okay, now return B by breaking the loop. Okay, so you got multiplicative inverse. We call this as new Q or capital Q. Now what is our result? What is our final result? Our final result is P into multiplicative inverse of Q modulus M. So our final result is equal to P into multiplicative inverse of Q modulus M. Now print the result. Okay. What happened? Parenthesis is missing. Actually, not necessary. No, because you convert it to integer, you need. Inputs are 4, 2, and 1. Okay. So, kindly check the answer. Input is 4 to 1, output is this, okay, did you get it? Run it, 4 problems, 2 are taken, 1 is prepared. Fine. Is this clear? What is the input? 4, 2, 1. And what is the output? Output is this. Okay. Now, what's the procedure? First, find probability of half pass. Okay. Whenever there is at least class you find probability of opposite. If it is passed, find failure, probability of opposite. Okay, express probability as numerator and denominator. Okay, and then find out multiplicative inverse of Q. Okay, find out multiplicative inverse of Q, and then P is multiplied by multiplicative inverse of Q. Okay, and for whole module is taken. For whole module is taken with M. Is this clear? Is this clear? So only 50 or 60 people are responding. What about others? Hope you understand it. Okay. So three steps: probability and multiplicative inverse and coprimes. So three concepts: probability, probability, then coprimes, and then multiplicative inverse. Here, whenever there is at least phrase, find out probability of opposite. Probability of opposite outcome. Opposite outcome. Okay. In this case, out of four, Kodu prepared one, but two questions are picked randomly. Okay, picked randomly. Same questions should come from other three if Kodu has to fail. If Kodu has to fail, that is three questions should come from two questions should come from three, and overall possibilities are 4-6. Okay, is this clear? This is 3-6. And 1 - 3/6 is also 3/6. Now P is 3 and Q is 6. Now they are not coprimes, so we should convert them into coprimes. By converting them into coprimes, P will become 1 and Q will become 2. Okay, now find out multiplicative inverse of Q, that is 2. So what you need to find out? 2 into sum x. Okay, whose module with M is equal to 1. Okay, so let us call this as capital Q. So find out capital Q, right? And then what you do, you multiply P with Q and take modulus with M. Okay, this is final solution. Is this clear? You can also apply extended Euclid algorithm for this. Okay. Is this clear? Did you understand it? Okay. So I conclude this here and let us move on to next problem. Next problem is really very, very interesting and I need paintbrush to explain it. So let us go to problem first. Lifeguard problem. Look here. So can you tell me? Can somebody tell me the scenario? A person is getting drowned here. Okay, here is a savior. The savior has to reach the person using shortest path. Okay, blue color is water and this color is earth. Okay, the sand, right? The man runs faster. The speed of man while running is more than the speed of the man while swimming. The man runs faster when he is running than swimming. Okay. So look here. A lifeguard, the person is sitting on a beach on a lookout for potential emergencies. He suddenly notices a person who is drowning and springs to action. He runs up to the sea with a speed F into V. He swims straight to the person at the rate V. Swimming is V, whereas running is F into V. Swimming is V. Running is F into V. F is something more than one. Both in straight lines. He wants to minimize the time taken to get to the person. Okay. So please see carefully. This is the line separating water and beach. Okay. Let this be x-axis. Okay. The lifeguard is sitting here at XLYL. The lifeguard is sitting at XLYL. Here is a person who is drowning. His coordinates are XD and YD. Okay. Okay, now the man runs in straight line. Suppose this is distance L1 and this is distance L2. Okay, he can run like this also. He can run like this also. But these journeys are in straight lines. Okay. Here velocity V equal to F into V. Here velocity is V. Okay. Now, it is better that he chooses smaller path in water and larger path on beach. Why? Now this velocity is less than this velocity. Clear? He could cover larger distance quite faster because velocity is more. But this distance, while covering this distance, velocity is less. Okay, so this may not be the solution. Sometimes this may not be, sometimes this may be solution. So I hope you understand it. Okay, here is a trade-off. Now look this diagram very carefully. I am here, I am the savior, lifeboat. I have lifeboat, and you are here, you are drowning. Okay, my velocity v equal to say 1 meter per second, say f is 1.2. So on the on beach my velocity is 1.2 meters per second. In water my velocity is 1 meter per second. Okay, is this clear? So this is xl comma 0, this is xg comma 0. Okay, so I can cross here and reach, or I can cross here and reach, I can cross here and reach, I can cross here and reach, I can cross here and reach. Okay, is this clear? So what I do is, for x varying between xl and xd, I find out the point of crossing and find out time taken for this and time taken for this. Okay, for all the paths I find out the time. I take that path where time is minimum. Is this clear? The time of traveling this is different from time of traveling here. Okay, it is not wise to go beyond this and come here. So I take these two as my edges. Okay, so Priyanka, did you understand it? Manisha, Samyukta, Sucharita, Anusha, Padmaja, Maunika, Bhavani, Ammu, Srinu. So let me know if you understand this or not. Is this clear? Say something. Okay. Now let us see the inputs. Say 1, 1, 1, 1 is lifeboat coordinate, 1, -1 is drowning person coordinate, 1.2 is the velocity on the beach. Okay, there are four inputs: x, xl, yl. Say xl yl, xd yd, and the velocity. I need to find out the time. Okay, now so let us do it. There are four inputs. Say xl comma yl is equal to 1, 1. Okay, xlyl is 1 comma 1, xd yd is equal to 1 comma minus 2, 1 comma minus 2. Okay, now velocity on the ground is 1.2. Velocity on the ground is 1.2. Okay, now T1, let us do one thing. Let us find out that minimum time. What do you want? You want minimum time. Okay, is this clear? How to get minimum time? Import a module by name sys. Let minimum is, worst case minimum is maximum number. This is minimum time. Okay, now for x varying from xl to xd, if you want to include xd also, put plus 1 in steps of 1. Okay, find out time on land. What is time on land? Let us call this as tl. Time on land is equal to, time is, what is time? Distance by velocity. What is distance? Assume that you are here. First you come here and then go here. Okay, this is xd, yd. Here velocity is f. Here velocity is 1. Now this point is x comma 0. This point is x comma 0. So what is distance? X minus xl whole square plus yl square under root. This is distance. What is velocity? F. What about this? This is x minus xd whole square plus yd square under root. Okay, distance by velocity. What is velocity? 1. This is t2. This is t1. Find out t. That is t1 plus t2. Okay, is this clear? Now let us find out the distances. TL is XL minus X. XL minus X whole square plus YL square root. Okay, for square root you have math. Say from math import all. Okay, now similarly find out t in water, t on land and t on water. Square root of x minus xd whole square plus yd square, because y is 0 on the separating layer. Now t is equal to TL, time on land plus time on water. Okay, now if t is less than minimum, then minimum is t. Okay, now print and optimum is x. Find optimum and time. Okay, Let us save this somewhere here. What happened? Unmatched parenthesis. X minus xt whole square plus yt square, square root. Okay, time is 1, optimum point is 1. The answer is also 1, okay? So answer is 1. So what is answer? Collision course, television sets, lazy student, lifeguard. Okay, optimized spot is for this input, answer is 1. Fine, is this clear? Did you understand it? Check the code as well. Okay. Now I will explain this graphically. And this is time. Okay. This is X. Say XL, XT. Initially time is more, at some point between x and this the time is less and then increase, and you need to find out this x. Okay, is this clear? And check the code. A coordinate geometry problem, simply a coordinate geometry problem and nothing else. Okay, and this is asked in code vita. They are testing your common sense. You are testing your basic mathematical skills and say common sense. Okay, so syntax of the language. Your yd is 1. Xd is -2. Yd is 1 and xt is -2. I would like to show you. This is 1 and this is 1. Okay, you are here. Next. Here is a person. Okay. This is drowning person, this is lifeboat. Is this clear? So where you should cross? You should cross here only. Okay. Here, 1 comma 0. Fine. Is this clear? Pujita, is this clear? Yd is -2. yd is minus 2. This is 1 only. Yd is minus 2. Okay. One minus one, okay. So let us take minus one. Let us take minus one and run this. What is answer? Pujita, what is answer? Answer is one only. Pujita, is this clear? Pujita, can you hear me? Okay. So tomorrow, the problems for tomorrow, we're going to solve monkey groove problem. Exchange of digits problem and stock span problem, both version 1 and version 2. Okay, so is this clear? So it is a mere coordinate geometry problem, even 10th class student can do it. So companies want you to be good up to 10th standard, at the most up to 12th standard. Okay, so hope these two problems are clear. Lifeguard and a lazy student. In lifeguard, distance and time. Okay, in lazy student, probability and modular arithmetic. Okay, is this clear? In probability, you need permutations and combinations. In modular arithmetic, you need GCD, coprimes, and multiplicative inverse. So these are the concepts required for many of the problems that might come in exam. Okay, so I take leave now. Hope you understood. Let us meet tomorrow at the same time. So let us end stream.